Hey, what's up, good people? Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Blue Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know this literally does not work. I'm down taking care of some business, and then we'll be hitting the road here, hopefully in the next hour, to get my behind back home. It's been a long, long week, and it's just getting started. So, the Combine. The Dallas Cowboys are in Indianapolis for the Combine. The thing that's interesting about the Combine is a lot of work gets done actually at the Combine. A lot of trades, you know, because this is all the teams having their owners and their GMs and their scouting departments and stuff that are there looking at prospects. And maybe they see somebody that they say, you know what, if we can target that guy, maybe we can get rid of this veteran here and there. You know, maybe we can get some more draft capital to be able to go for one guy or the other. And, you know, this is a chance to kind of, you know, under the table, have conversations about guys that might want to be traded and stuff. So expect to see a lot of work and a lot of things to happen this week, especially with us only being 2 weeks away from the beginning of free agency. And so this is where the Cowboys have that 2 weeks of time to try and get themselves under the cap, as well as figure out who's going to be here. Stephen Jones was asked if they've made decisions on Amari Cooper, whether or not Amari Cooper will be here or won't be, as well as others like DeMarcus Lawrence. And his comments on this are, there's a lot of moving parts to these situations, and of course the high dollar individuals will get scrutinized more than others. You understand that? So in other words, they haven't decided on what they're going to do. Now, for me, I believe that Amari Cooper is a more integral part of the Dallas Cowboys offense than DeMarcus Lawrence is on the defense. The reason I say that is you actually look from DeMarcus Lawrence actually having his leg, you know, his foot broken in practice after week one, the progression that you got from Micah Parsons and the ability of the Dallas Cowboys defense, they played actually better when DeMarcus Lawrence wasn't on the field. That's not to say that DeMarcus Lawrence isn't a great player. I think what it is I think that Micah Parsons ended up giving you more pressure from the outside than what you were getting with DeMarcus Lawrence, because DeMarcus Lawrence is a little bit bigger, a little bit heavier, a little bit slower coming off of injuries, where you had a young pup who is fast, strong, with great hands. And the key now in the NFL is making that quarterback uncomfortable. Yes, Micah Parsons had a great season, whether it was playing defensive end, playing, you know, linebacker, hell, being a center fielder. He's great everywhere. But if you honestly want to get the biggest bang that you can for your buck, I believe it's him being a pass rusher. And that's why you looked at it and said, okay, the defense didn't miss a stride too much with DeMarcus Lawrence gone. On the flip side of that, you look at how the first half of the season, how the offense was humming, and Amari Cooper was a bigger part of that. The second half of the season, you saw without Amari Cooper, how the offense wasn't quite as effective. You know, they moved the ball and stuff, but they weren't the same team. And you look at that and say, you know, with Amari Cooper there, but not really there, being used as a weapon, that the offense suffered, and they should have been using him more down the stretch than what they were. That goes to play calling and things like that. But I honestly believe that if you end up getting rid of Amari Cooper, you're going to have a void in this offense. You are going to suffer greatly, greatly with this if you end up getting rid of Amari Cooper. I think the Dallas Cowboys, if they ended up letting DeMarcus Lawrence go, the money that they save, you know, to be, depending on if they make it an instant hit or if it's a June 1st cut, that $19 million that they have that they can use towards replacement players to be able to say, let's get a linebacker, let's get a one technique monster in there and get some of that money down on where we're over on the salary cap, I think it's more beneficial for the team. If it were me, I've gone through and I've said this stuff a couple of times, I would restructure Amari Cooper's deal, because Amari Cooper's long-term, because he's only had that $40 million guaranteed, which has already been paid, that his deal long term will be cheaper to restructure. It won't be as painful down the road as if you restructure DeMarcus Lawrence. And I think the upside for Amari Cooper, who doesn't have quite the same injury history as DeMarcus Lawrence does in recent years. He's had two back surgery. He's had the broken foot. He's had the torn labrum. And the amount of abuse that you take as a defensive end, you don't all of a sudden just get past the injuries. No, you don't. It's all of a sudden now, you're going to have more and more of those. And seeing that $27 million hit that we're taking, that's just too much. It's way too much. But it's up to the Cowboys to determine. You know, we can talk till our face is blue on what we think the Cowboys need. And let's be clear, managing a football team, it's hard. It's really hard to figure out who to spend the money on. And you look at some of these deals, when you pay all this money, you expect to go ahead and get a return on it. Sadly, very rarely can you look at a contract and say, wow, the Cowboys, other than Tyron Smith. Tyron Smith, you can't argue with Tyron Smith. But again, now he's getting older. Very rarely do you have contracts like Tyron Smith where you say, man, we got our money's worth out of that guy. More times than not, they're kind of like the Miles Austin, where you paid him a whole bunch of money after, you know, one really good year. And you end up releasing him with still a whole bunch of money that's still owed to him and looking and saying, damn, we got ripped off. And the hard part on this stuff is, the hardest part on this is, these players, especially with the Dallas Cowboys, because they're America's team, because everybody's got a show, because they're a vital part of the community and they live, you know, in Dallas and Dallas, you know, Metroplex area, that they become part of the community and part of the family. And I think that happens more with the Cowboys than it does maybe with other locations. I don't know that the Jets players are really embraced in the same way as the Dallas Cowboys ones are. And we get emotionally tied to keeping them. And a lot of times what happens is we just hold on for too long. And we say, we can't live without that guy. There were so many people that when Jalen Smith was cut, it's like, oh, we can't lose Jalen Smith, man. Oh, he's going to come back to haunt us. And we have this fear of letting people go. We always think that we can't make it without somebody. I hate to keep pointing to 2014, but in 2013, we let go of Marcus Ware, cornerstone of the franchise, Jason Hatcher after 11 sacks, and Sean Lee, who tore up his knee. And the defense went from 32nd to 19th. It's just the way it is. All right. Peace out, guys.